essentially, they have painted a very simplistic narrative that the government has not considered these alternatives, that we are on autopilot, we are not open to ideas, we are just stubbornly pushing away at something we decided to do anyway. But that's completely false. It's completely false. Because we've gone through this already in the budget debate. I've explained repeatedly that in the budget debate that we had thought about all the options very carefully, explained why many of these alternatives are not substitutes for GST. I've gone through them again today. In fact, I've said it's not just GST, all these alternatives. We have to consider so many different options together given our huge funding gap. And I've also explained that we have studied this carefully before we made the decision, the very difficult decision to proceed, both in the budget and after the budget. So this false and simplistic narrative painted by the Workers' Party, which, as Mr. Murali Pillai has kindly reminded us, is not the first time. Pattern of repeating the same arguments against the GST time and again. Really, it does not do justice to the commitment and professionalism of the entire team in MOF, including the public officials who are trying so hard to do what is right and to pursue a strategy of fiscal responsibility and discipline for the benefit of Singapore and Singaporeans. To be clear, the Workers' Party is entitled to your own position. By all means, oppose the GST, adopt a different position, fine. But at least be honest and responsible. Acknowledge that your alternatives will either end up requiring the middle income to pay more or will use more of the past reserves, therefore denying less for the next generation. And at least have the decency to acknowledge that the government had considered all of these alternatives carefully. We debated them in the budget thoroughly and rigorously before we decided on this move. I would have thought that's what a responsible political party would have done. Unfortunately, I'm very disappointed that the Workers' Party has chosen to take a different path. And I wonder if this is because they feel that this approach is the best way to advance their political agenda, as they have been over the years, to paint the PAP government as uncaring and out of touch.